God's been getting you ready all this time. Say it.
Because there's a job has to be done, and we don't have much time. The end of an age is fastly approaching us. That means you and I got to get in what? Hurry. That's why when Brother Kilpatrick mentioned about levels and how long it takes to get from one level to another, and that word level has been preeminent in the body of Christ. But he came to us with a greater revelation that how the levels takes time, but in dimension can happen when? Now. Can you say amen? So God wants us to step into a new dimension because we don't have much what? Time. You understand that? Praise God. Jesus Christ is soon to come. Amen. And I want to be what? Ready. Not only ready, but I want to bring as many people as I can. Hallelujah. Right on Barker said, we want to plunder hell and fill heaven. He's right about that. Amen. And you and I have a responsibility. Amen. Praise God. To win the loss. That's not, it's not pleasing to a lot of people in the body. But you need to know your responsibility. The greatest thing God called you to do is win the loss. You may be involved in a lot of church stuff. But Jesus said, I came to seek and to save that which was what? Lost. Now you may have a lot of other things, side issues. But that's the main thing. Say, all nations, let the main thing be the main thing. And there are a lot of folk out there that don't know God. And I think I mentioned this Thursday night. I was teaching this about how Jesus said to me last Saturday down in the basement. We were praying. The Lord spoke this very loud to me. He says, leave the 99 and go find the one. So I was trying to share it with the church. You know, if somebody is lost, they got to be found. You just can't haphazardly find folk. You got to go find them on what? Purpose. So you and I got to engage. I'm preaching right now. You got to engage your time, your talent, your finances, and your will to go win the who? The loss. Shout hallelujah. And when the Lord told me that, I pondered about it. I said, well, God, what about the 99? He said to me, the 99 have each other. They can comfort each other. They can strengthen each other. See, we're here now. We can strengthen each other. We can comfort one another. But what about the one out there that's what? That's lost. A lost person can't find their way. Amen. I know when I've traveled and I've gotten lost, amen, the peace goes away. There's an uncomfortableness coming to my car. Shout hallelujah. And then if we're not careful, we be fighting about or arguing about which way is right. Turn left, turn right. I know. When the fact of the matter is, both of us was lost. But when we find somebody that know the way, somebody may drive past us and stop at the light, and we roll the window down and say, sir, can you tell me so-and-so? He said, go down three blocks, make a right, turn right on Jericho, and you're there. When that man leaves, guess what? My heart is pleased. Why? I got assurance. Amen? Say, so you get ready to say something to us. So you ought not come to this church next week without somebody. You know, I was telling the church this morning, yesterday I got a call from a preacher. I know him. Matter of fact, I saw him at the Kilpatrick. I invited him just over the internet. I texted him. And he had asked me to do something for him, I don't know, a couple of months ago, be a part of something they was having at their church. I couldn't be there, but financially I could be a part. And so I invited him over the texting to come to Brother Kilpatrick. He came. We never ever really talked, no more than maybe 15 minutes at a time. And that's probably two times in the last 10 years. So he calls me yesterday. He said, Pastor Simon. I said, yes. He said, this is Brother Pastor so-and-so. I said, oh, yeah. So I remember seeing you with Brother Kilpatrick. He said, I'm kind of nervous. I said, what are you nervous about? He said, the Lord gave me a word for you, and I'm just kind of nervous. I said, you don't have to be nervous. I'm easy. Hallelujah. But anyway, the word of the Lord that he gave is out of 2 Kings. But this is what it says in jest. He says that God has given you instructions and he's given you a charge to tell the people. I'm just telling you what he told me. He said, the Lord says that he sees that most of the people that are good people don't have a mind to do it. But to tell me to be encouraged, he's getting ready to send another people that will help me to get done what he's called. Now, I say that not to bring any condemnation, nothing like that. I'm saying, and so if you're not doing something, be a one that can be a part. You understand? Because I'm going to tell you something. If you don't get this now, I don't know if I can ever explain it to you. The heart of God is the harvest of God. That's his heart. Can you say amen? Now, how many know we can say we love the sinner and all like that? Words, faith without works is what? Dead. So let's get busy bringing God to the reward of his suffering. He died for all humanity. And of all we going to go do, let's make sure. Now, there are 168 hours in the week, I believe. I was saying this on Thursday night. And if you dedicate just 4 hours to God a week out of 168 hours, that ain't very much. Or if you dedicate 2 hours, that's almost nothing. Come on, somebody. So all you got to do is say pray and pray. Say, God, help me to do and be purposed toward winning the lost. That means you got to leave your house and leave your zip code and go out there. And for those of you to say you got to be led by God, I believe that. But the scripture leads you. Jesus said, go into what? All the world. That's the leadership. Now, if you want particular leadership, you have a right while you're going to say, now, Lord, you show me. But as far as knowing to go, the leadership of the Holy Spirit is the word of God. The word tells you to what? Go. Listen, there's some people out there waiting right now. Come what? Help me. Why? Lost. And when God told me to leave the 99, he was impressing me. Thank God for the church. But what about the lost? See, we're not careful. We be a selfish people. We'll all want more joy, more anointing, more gifting moving in our life, and never do anything with it. Somebody say amen. I talked this Tuesday night. The church was quiet. You could hear pins falling. But the bottom line is we just got to recognize we love God. We're good people. We want to please God. But there's an area in our life we need what? Help in. Well, And I was told, and I believe this, that I need to have some classes about teaching about soul winning and all like that. I believe that we can enhance our ability to win the loss. But the Lord gave me this, and I believe this. You have your own testimony. Your testimony alone will win the loss. Praise God. Remember the man said, all I know is I was blind. Now I see. That'll win somebody to Christ. And when you first got saved, you told folk. Now, the question is, now, 5 years later, we're not telling them. Is it still not good? Is the joy not there? Are you not still glad about how God, what, brought you out? Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Well, praise God. It's kind of quiet, too. Hallelujah. Amen? Yes, we can have soul winning and outreach teams. That's fine. But that does not negate your responsibility to be the light. And yes, it's fine. You go to Walgreens and somebody's up. You hear somebody talking about being sick. You turn around and minister to them. That's a great opportunity. But you didn't go there to do that. You went there to get something in Walgreens. And happenstance allowed you a chance. That's wonderful. But I'm talking about on what? Purpose. See, I came to church this morning on what? Purpose. It wasn't happenstance. I knew last night or all week long, come Sunday morning, God let me live, I'm going to the house of God. Well, you got to say, amen, God let me live, I'm going to the what? Harvest. Let me say something. Listen, sometimes we ain't got to go far. We got folk in our own family. But now, how many know most of the time our family members don't listen to us? They listen to other people. So go find, if you got a son and need to be saved, go find another son. You got a brother need to be saved? Find another brother. Got a wife, a sister, whatever? Go find what? Somebody else. And God will anoint you. I say he'll anoint you. I say he will anoint you. And by the way, you're already anointed. You just don't know how anointed you are because you're not exercising. Amen. You get to talking to somebody about Jesus and how he died. I don't mean braggadocious. I'm preaching right now. I don't mean braggadocious. I don't mean pride, but I mean tell them how bad you were. Tell them how if it had not been for God, amen, you might be in hell right now. Because the truth of the matter is, that is the truth. The only reason we're alive right now, God is having mercy on us right now. Lamentations say it is of the Lord's mercy that we're not consumed. for they are new when? Every morning. So it's the mercy of God that give us our eyes to see and hands to touch and legs to walk, mouth to talk. God gave you all of that for the glory of God. Go tell it. Say, go tell it. Remember that song? Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills, and what? Everywhere. We sing that at Christmas. But that ought to be a reality when? All the time. And I say to you this morning as a pastor and the authority that God has put in my life, all, amen, furloughs are canceled. Hallelujah, amen. You know, in the army, you get a furlough. But all furloughs are canceled right now. Right now, the will of God has to be done. Why? We don't have much what? Time. And if you ask God, go to praying and ask God about it. I promise you, he'll tell you, he's in a hurry. He knows the time is what? Short. Shout hallelujah. Don't you see the perversion and the difficulty that are arising in our nation? All of that is the spirit of the Antichrist. Brother Moyer preached in the bottom of the church this morning. He talked about this new law, HR, whatever you want to call it. But it gives the right, it gives same rights to the lesbian and the gays. If I have a business, if I don't hire this lesbian person, or this homosexual, they'll call it discrimination. They can take me to court. Amen. And even in the church, I want to hire a Christian, Holy Ghost filled person to be a campus pastor. And the lesbian or the homosexual can take me to court. No, not because of their religion or their lack of, but because of their what? Their rights. Now listen, the Constitution don't give the homosexual or the lesbian the right. Neither does the Scripture. But I mention that because I want you to know we're in a wicked time. And the devil, while the church is sitting down being comfortable, the devil is slipping in and throwing stuff in there. And all of a sudden, we're in what? Trouble. Come on, somebody. Amen. If you've been slothful in God, amen, ask God, say, help me, God. Hallelujah. The Bible said, work while it's what? Day. The night coming, what? No man can work. If you don't know, listen, I'm not against a vacation. Go get your vacation. You need that. But come back ready to work. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm not against a scourge and taking a weekend off. Praise God. I mean, that's human. We're not talking about that. We're talking about having a consistent desire to fulfill the will of God and to do our part. Shout hallelujah. God said, arise and do your what? Part. All of us got a part. Just like spiritually, all of us have a portion. Well, if you got a portion, you got a part. Say amen to that. All right, I'm going to the scriptures now. Shout hallelujah. Amen, somebody. I'm glad I still remember what it was like to have gotten saved. And when I got saved, I'd tell a grasshopper. Glory to God. Anybody that would listen, I'd tell it. It was inside of me. I'd go anywhere. I don't care if they made light of me. I told it. Why? I was glad for who was inside of me. Praise God. And see, that's why we need revival, so God can replenish and restore that passion, that craving to please God and tell the world God is a good God. Shout hallelujah. And somebody said to me, according to the scripture in Luke 15, the prodigal, you know, son was out there lost in somewhere out there in the world. He left his dad a house. That's just a type of leaving the father. But the Bible said the father was always there, what? Waiting. Every day the father walked out of his house, stood on the outside, waiting on his son to come where? Home. Well, God the Father is waiting when? Now. You say, well, why don't the father go? He does. Through us. We are his sheep. We are his disciples. He commanded us to what? Go. Boy, that's the word. Say, go. Go where? Go ye into what? All the world. That means in every corner of our neighborhood. We ought to sweep Jackson clean where we have to go to another county. Glory to God. Where they at? On your street. On my street. On your block. On my block. Shout hallelujah. Otherwise, hear me well. Otherwise, amen, we'll be sitting here, praise God, putting more paint on a bond that don't need to be painted. Run. You hear me in the spirit? Run. That's what God is saying. What? Run. Why? Time is what? Short. Hallelujah. The good news about when that father was on the outside waiting for that prodigal to come home, praise God, the father didn't have no condemnation. He wasn't bitter. He wasn't mad. Now, I'm going to tell you who was mad. Part of the 99. Because the older son was at home and got angry because God was restoring. And see, part of the problem with the church is folk done left some people done left the 99, the 100, and got out there, amen, and messed up. And now we want to keep them out there. No, that's what? Bring them back. You got anybody in your house need to come back? Yeah, we do. Well, don't beat them up. Don't lambash them. Pray them in. Fast them in. Love them in. Show them compassion. Show them mercy. They're waiting on God. I think I said this Thursday night, but I don't mind being redundant. There was a young kid that died over in Ellerton Heights, I think last Saturday. 3 years old. His mom was in the house, and the boyfriend was in the house. The boyfriend had a gun. The child found the gun. 3 years old. The gun was loaded, shot, killed itself. The other day, the mother and father was in the court, and I happened to be getting ready for church for Bolivar, and I happened to look at that, and I saw the mother. And I looked at my wife. I said, you know what? I don't care what has happened. She must have loved her child. You know, even bad mamas don't do everything right, still love their children. Like bad daddies. And the young man was sitting there, and she was standing before the judge, and my heart went out to her. But let me tell you what happened to me. First came out of me, shame. That's a shame for them to allow that to happen to that child. Then the Lord come back behind that. He said, no, the shame is that they were there and nobody have gone by to tell them about me. So before we condemn folk, before we want to beat somebody up, make sure you've done your job. And even if you've done your job, you're not condemning anybody. Yeah, it was bad that that child's life is gone, but that child now is in the presence of God. Now that, hey man, praise God. The child can't go to them, but they can still, even in spite of being in jail or whatever the thing is, they can go to where? God. Are you listening to me? God wants us to come out of Abasiki and Yoshaya. He wants us to come out of Abasiki and Odoshe. Let's say, touch your neighbor. Say, don't be lazy. Be fervent. Glory to God. Say, be fervent. Hallelujah. Listen, on our college campuses, there are so many lost folk kids that learned about God, trained up at home, go to these campuses that are so liberal, anti-God, we have Christian colleges in this city with professors in there that are anti-God in a Christian school. My God, who would hire that person? My God, who's hiring? If you're going to get somebody to teach Christian principles, you ought to at least have a Christian. Or at least a person that says, hey man, I'm going to obey the curriculum no matter what I believe. But a lot of these kids are getting lost in the house. Why? Because they don't have the right kind of teachers. Hallelujah. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't want to be lost, do you? No, 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 no. I want to be found, praise God. Hallelujah. And I want somebody to love me enough. In that song about Reckless Love. You hear that song talk about leaving the 99? Man, when I heard that the other night, when I was teaching, I could hear that song. Ain't no mountain whatever it says. Ain't no lie. He'll tear down any lie, any wall, whatever it is. The songwriter said, I love you that much. And I want you to know some God is in love with the sinner. We say he mad at them, but God loves them. And we got to get in our heart where we get that kind of love in our hearts for them, where we'll display and shower them with the what? Love of God. Yeah, folk done messed up, but you and I messed up. Come on now, how many of you remember when you were not saved? Excuse me. How many remember even in your salvation, you need God to help you? Why? God loves you. God ain't want to throw you away. God want to gather you up. Shout hallelujah. Stop judging, folk. You ain't, amen. We all have sinned. Romans 3:23 says, and come short of the what? Glory of God. Come on now. Hallelujah. We making plans for everything except the kingdom. I said, we making plans for everything except the kingdom. The Bible says in Proverbs 3:6, in all your ways, acknowledge God, and he will direct your what? Path. Which one of us this morning have said in the beginning of the year, God, I want my year to be better toward the kingdom of God. I said it. How many said we're going to win some souls to God this year? but had made no efforts. You know what that is? That's a tinkling cymbal and a sounding brass. Are you listening? Yeah, I am indebted to God to win the loss. Did you know that? We are in debt to God to tell the world Jesus saves. Can you say amen to that? Yeah, and listen, the more you get out there and do it, amen, the more you're going to get excited, because you're going to be pulling people out of the very fires of hell into the kingdom of who? God. And the way you do that is just keep remembering, if it had not been for the Lord, the psalmist said, who was on our side, we too would have been what? Swallowed up. I don't want to be swallowed up except in the love of God. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. When I look at Darwin back there on that college campus at Bethel, and he's ministering there, his job, his heart is to win the loss. Amen. Now, amen, some of us are not bold enough to do that, but he's bold enough. Shout hallelujah. But I remember when I was a sinner, I was bold as a lion. Say anything, any kind of word. Profanity was easy for me. You hear me? Talk about somebody, mama ain't never met him. Come on now. Y'all forgot where you were? How you were? Praise God. No, you haven't forgotten. Jesus, I'll never forget. No, never. What you done for me. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Yeah, I was lost. Bold as a lion. Cuss anybody. Talk about anybody's mama. Because the spirit, that father that I was serving was not God. It was the devil. Because before you get saved, the devil is your what? Father. And everybody need a new father. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Listen to me this morning. I'm just admonishing you to get busy. Not just talking. James said, faith without works is what? Dead. Now, I've said what I'm saying this morning. I've said it lots of times. And I've had affirmation of amen. Amen. Lots of times. But it's not me you're trying to please. Understand that. I'm not telling you this for my sake. I'm telling you this because God told me. And my job is to deliver the mail. And this morning, whether you like it or not, your mail is being delivered. It's up to you to what? Read the mail. Come on, somebody. All of us need to get out there and get busy for who? God. And by the way, God said, whatever is right, I'm going to what? Pay you. And I don't know nobody got better benefits than God. Nobody. Amen. Your hip hurting you? Get out there and hop out there. After a while, that hip be just fine. Why? Because God needs you. Say, God needs me. Get out there trying to do it when you're not feeling well and watch healing come. You can't give and not what? Receive. Are you listening to me? Glory to God. This is no hour to run away from the will of God. This is an hour to run straight into the what? Will of God. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Hallelujah. The church got upset when the prodigal son come home. The older son represents the church. He got upset. He got mad. That grieved the father. The father said, you've been with me all the time. All that I ever had has been yours. Listen to me, church. Amen. You've been privileged like I have, part of the body, to have the anointing of God on our life, to have the fellowship of the Holy Ghost, have the word of God being revealed to us. We've always had that as long as we've been saved. Why would we get upset with somebody that's been out there in the dark coming to the what? Light. No, we ought to shower them with the love of God, with the go ahead. You can make it. Shout hallelujah. There's a gentleman that come on 101.5. He's out of mile, and I'm trying to think what his name is. People think something wrong with him because he called the radio station. And they put up with him a little bit, and then finally they'll just hang up on him. He'll call in there, and he said, you know, I just want you to know, I was out. He got an old raggedy-looking truck, and he go cut people yards that can't cut their yards for free. He called him. He said, the Lord tells me to do this. He said, I enjoy it. He said, I'm just trying to win people to the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, after a while, they'll cut him off. But he, you know what? He called back the next day. They know his name. They think a little something wrong with him. Now, something wrong with the people that's got the what we call the right mind, but not doing the right thing. That's where the wrong is. I'll take that man over a whole lot of folk. Why? He has a burden for the lost. He has the what? Heart of God. And you don't have to be so highly intelligent. to win somebody to Jesus. Glory to God. It used to be, well, the man, I guess he's still living. It was a man that had cerebral palsy. I can't think what his name is. He's a preacher. Jerry Falwell used to have him at his church a lot. And, you know, he stuttered and tell his story. But, man, he could land that gospel. And people would get saved. He wasn't, I mean, listen, I'm not saying he wasn't intelligent, but he couldn't get his words together. And you know, he had different things about his body. But the one thing he had together was the knowledge that Jesus saved, and he'll save anybody. You and I, listen, there are a lot of things I want to learn, but I want to learn nothing more than I want to learn the ways of God. Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, take my yoke upon me. And what? Learn of me. I want to what? Learn of God. Learn the ways of God. There are some things God want to reveal to the church now that no other age has had. And if your mind is all in a whole lot of other places, you're not going to be able to give your mind to God. So set your affection, Colossians says, chapter 2, on things where? Above. So look up. Glory to God. When the sinner man see us like we all so troubled and ain't nothing working out and everything, you're not winning that person. You're pushing him further back in the world. Because sinners will say, I had it bad. Where? In the world. There's a man here, his wife just died, I think, last year. Put out a song about I can do bad by myself. Super Wolf wife. She wrote that song, amen. And I can do bad by myself. But with the help of somebody, I can do what? Better. Two is better than one. And a three women card is hard to be what? Broken. You and I are part of the kingdom of God. God last day church to reach out to a last day generation that's perishing. And God is saying, where you go? I hear the Savior say. Can you hear God? Can you hear him? Listen, ignore me. Just hear the voice this morning. Don't get mad at the pastor because I'm delivering some mail that we might not want to hear. But all of us need some help. All of us need to be in a prayer meeting and say, God, we're sorry that the lost are dying and we haven't done very much about it. Now, that's a hard pill to swallow. But how many know how you get better is when you acknowledge what you've done wrong. Shout hallelujah. Glory to God. No, the Lord said this to me and I said to you this morning. The church, the corporate body of Christ, is so sensitive now that you can't hardly say some things to them that they need to hear. Because people get offended over the least little thing. But Jesus said, blessed are they that are not offended where? In me. And by the way, offense can't come unless you accept it. If you don't take it, it can't come. At least it won't be a part of your life. And offense comes because we're immature. We won't grow up. Yeah, somebody said something bad to me. So gone. When you go out there to win the loss, someone may curse you. Someone may lie, say ugly stuff. Gone. Say next. Don't come home and say, you know, they don't want to be saved. That's contrary to the scripture. The harvest is where I'm going this morning, but I'm already there. It's white, but the laborers are what? Few. Pray. Somebody said, pray that the Lord of the harvest will send forth what? Laborers. So my job is to pray that you and I will get up and be a what? Laborer. You say, well, Pastor Simon, I labor, and I minister to a lot of people. But check this out. You examine it. You ain't got to believe me. Most of the people you minister to are already saved. Tell me the ones that you minister to that's not saved. Show me that number. That means we're keeping it in the house. Yeah, and by the way, it's easier to minister to those that's already saved. And I'm not saying they don't need ministering to, but what about the greater call is to the what? World. Go ye into what? All the world. Hallelujah. Well, hallelujah. I said, well, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go to Matthew 28 if you have your Bibles. Amen. I hope this is encouraging you to say, Lord, listen, I'm going to do my best. Hallelujah. Mark 28, do you have your Bibles? Hallelujah. How many received Matthew chapter number 28? How many know that God gave you what? Power. Say that. Power. Power in the lack of power in a car battery, though the car has everything there to move with, It won't go anywhere. Because it has, that battery has to be empowered to cause the rest of that car to go, right? Hallelujah. Jesus told them, disciples, amen, go to Jerusalem and tarry. Or wait until they were endued with what? Power. After that, amen, the Holy Ghost. With what? Power. What kind of power? Say Holy Ghost. Power. And how many know the Holy Ghost is not timid, is not shy, is not bashful. Amen. It's not insecure. It's not weak. It's not barren. It's power. Say it. Power. The Holy Ghost will roll you in the floor. But that same Holy Ghost will roll you in the floor. Will roll you down the highway. Walk you down your street. Hallelujah. Amen. You go to McDonald's, praise God. You know, amen. Amen. I go there on purpose to witness. Amen. I give me a cup of tea and I start talking to three or four young folk. Amen. I'm trying to bring them into Christ. I ask them, I don't go right there. I say, how you doing? Are you in school? Yes, sir. Are you going to college? Yes, sir. And then I go right on in there to Jesus. And then get saved while they cross the counter. Well, it'll take a long time to be saved. That's just three questions. Amen. 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 If you died today, would you go to heaven? No, sir. Would you like to go? Question number two. Yes, sir. All right, let me lead you to Christ. Number three, you saved. Well, I don't know about that. See, the saving part is God's. My part is a talent. People walk down the aisle on Sunday morning. You may feel like they're not saved. That's not between you and them. That's between them and who? God. God knows our hearts. I feel better now. Hallelujah. I say, God knows our hearts. We need to get a passion back for the lost. That's what the Spirit of God is saying. Go get my harvest. And I say it again, most of the church people are involved in ministering to church people, which is good, but it's not the main thing. Hallelujah. When Jesus taught those disciples for 3.5 years, he sent them out, right? Peter stood up on the day when the Holy Ghost was outpoured. He got filled in Acts chapter 2 with the Holy Spirit. Amen. In Acts chapter number 3, I believe, or chapter number 5, Peter stood up and preached, and 3,000 folk got saved, right? So 3,000 what? Believers. How did the gospel spread? Those 3,000 people got saved and went told it. Now, how many want to take the city? You cannot, listen to me well. You can't take it sitting down here doing this. Hallelujah. Yes, God told me that he gave me the city, but now he's not going to give it to me if we don't what? Take it. The kingdom of heaven suffers what? Violence. But the violence suffers, amen, taken by what? Force. What is that force? Force of what? Faith. Say, we can have Jackson, but not sitting down. Pastor, I mean, I got it. You ain't got to tell me that over and over again. I'm telling you in every way I can. Shout hallelujah. God, amen, amen. They got in that in Matthew 28, he gives them the Great Commission. Jesus had died and rose again. He's giving them some last few words. He said, go ye into what? All the world. Well, first he said, all power in heaven and earth has been given what? Unto me. But what he's saying is, but I'm going to give you all what I got. Now, every person here needs the baptism of the Holy Ghost to be a very effective person because the world out there is not easy. It's some dark stuff out there. It's some folk out there got demons in them. You don't believe it? Get out there and know how the real thing. But you're not to let fear hold you back because greater is he that's in who? Us. Than he that's where? In the world. You and I. Hallelujah. Next week we ought to be bringing people that we have won to Christ. And if they don't want to come to this church, fine. Amen. Get them saved and direct them to a church. We're not talking about trying to build all nations in terms of numerical. We're trying to build the kingdom. And the kingdom and building a local assembly can be different. Do I want people to be a part? Yes, I do. But that's not my main goal. My main goal is to lead them out of the sin into the righteousness of God. Shout hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Let me read this now. I hurry and let you go. I think. Verse 18. And Matthew 28, and Jesus came and spake unto them, the apostles, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and earth. I just said that. Then he gives them that commission. Go ye, therefore, and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe what? All things. But you can't begin to teach somebody until you've won them. I got to win you and then teach you. Come on now, I got to get you born again. Because if that, amen, you ain't born again, I'm trying to teach you, you're going to miss it. Because the carnal mind cannot receive anything from God. When you got saved, then God began to what? Teach you. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Say, go ye. Uh-huh. Say, I got to go ye. Somebody said, what's wrong with you? Say, I got to go ye. Go ye where? Walmart. Yeah, if they there, go there. Now go to Acts chapter 1. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Praise God. Say, revival is coming. Not many days hence. Glory to God. Y'all think I'm just talking. I'm not just talking. Hallelujah. I've been assured by God. He told me to press into revival. I've been assured about it. But wait, man, we saw a pastor, it's revival is coming. We ain't got to worry about winning the loss. That's not going to change. When revival comes and the Spirit of God falls on us, we still got to go. Even though there may be hundreds of people, 1,000 coming, we still got to go. Because for as many as coming, there's still as many out there what? Lost. See, that's one of the dangers for pastors. They get a growing congregation and it fills up. And so then they stop putting emphasis on winning the loss. Because we have arrived. But how many know we don't arrive till we leave here? Shout hallelujah. I had a man tell me, he said, man, if I had many members of you, God, I'd be done quit. And I laughed at him. I'm talking about a preacher. I said, man, what's wrong with you? The harvest is white. Jesus said, there's still what? Room. Remember the song, there's room at the cross. Yes, there's still what? Room. Shout hallelujah. And I both see kind of Yahshua. I'll tell you what you do. You both say, I hear you, Lord. You don't. Some of you don't trust what I'm telling you. Start praying in the Holy Ghost when you get home this evening. See, don't God change your, you know, Brother Kilpatrick says, the dimension God is bringing us in is going to change our thoughts. Start praying. Soon on to begin to change your thoughts. Because see, if we're not careful, though we've been in the Lord for a while, a short while, or a long while, we can have a set mind. But your mind ought to be pliable. It ought to be able to be what? Changed. Inspired. Amen. Say, Lord, I want to know more about you. Hallelujah. Man, you get out there and go to winning the loss and trying to win something, you almost got the fish on the bank. Glory to God. I can tell when I'm out there witnessing which way the fish is going. If that fish about to come in, I don't spend no long time. I just bring them right on in. I done told them enough to bring them where? Here. And most people are not arrogant. I mean, even sinners out there, they're not arrogant. You get to talking about God, look like God blesses you with a holy reverence where they have a respect about what you're saying. Now, somebody over there might say, man, I ain't studying that so-and-so, so-and-so. You just ignore them. Bring this fish in. Glory to God. Amen. And ignore that fish. Go on to another fish. Another day for that one. Hallelujah. Are you in Acts? Acts chapter 1. Are you there? This is why the baptism of the Holy Ghost needs to be preached all over the world today. Because it is an empowerment from God that allows you to be what the scripture said, witness. Are you listening to me? All of us are God's what? Witness. If you're a witness in a courtroom, you're there to testify about what you what? Know. You can't testify about what you don't know. Verse number 4, and being assembled together with them, commanded them, say he commanded them, that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise. Woo, my. For the what? Promise. The Holy Ghost is a what? Promise. My God. Hallelujah. Amen. He said, me and Simon together, he commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of my Father, which said he, you've heard of me. You know what Jesus, what don't ask and say, you done heard about this. But wait on it. And if you are here today and you've never been baptized with the Holy Ghost and you're a born-again person, you need this baptism. Why? It helps you to do the what? Will of God. You run into a devil, you've been in what? Powered. You ain't got to be afraid of the devil when you're full of the Holy Ghost. Truth is, he's afraid of you. Now, he'll act like he's not, but he know the authority. That's why I don't believe you got to tell him. You're dealing with somebody, a demon. Come on out. Come on out. Oh, come on out. In the name of Jesus. In the name of the Father. In the name. You ain't got to do all that stuff. That spiritual exercise, that's wrong. No, mean what you say. Say what you mean with the authority of God. Come on out. I command you in the name of Jesus. Come where? Out of that person. Come on, church. Listen, even the body don't fully believe that right now. But God said, I gave you what? Power over all the power of the devil. Luke chapter 10. And nothing, that's what the word said, by any means shall what? Hurt you. So why are you afraid to run out there? He said, I gave you power over all the power of the devil. And nothing. So don't let the devil tell you about it. That, you know, you got muggles out there. You got robbers. You do. I'm not belittling that. But he said, nothing. And I gave you power over all the power. Brother Moorhead made something clear this morning. He said, the devil is a defeated foe. He's been defeated. Not going to be. Is. Has been. Now. The only reason he's not defeated in your life is because you allow him. The Bible said in Mark, you shall tread upon who? Serpents. Walk all over the devil. The unfortunate thing is he's been walking over some of us. Yeah, we love God, but we're not walking in our authority. Know what you have. Walk in what you have. Exercise what you have. Demons are afraid of a blood-bought, Holy Ghost-filled, power-walking body of Christ. See, they're afraid of us. See, that's why we can't have casual gospel. You got to have the real truth. Shout hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. We got to have somebody telling the church, amen, you got to know who you are and know whose you are and know what you have. Glory to God. I told you about the policeman, I think, last week. Amen. Or whatever week. Amen. He got a badge up there. That's a sign of his authority. But his power is right down here in that gun. The badge is to make you what? Respect. The gun is to stop you if you don't respect. Say, God has given us a name that's above what? Every name. What's that name? Jesus. Glory to God. I'm going to tell you something. We've been trying to use psychology and trying to get the devil out of folk, but the only thing going to get the devil out of them is the name of who? Jesus. And then in Matthew 18, he says, if two or three of you would touch and agree concerning what? Say anything that they ask in my name, I will what? Do it. And Brother Moorhead made an expression about Jesse LaPlantis, preached a message about, I'll be you too. No, if you say you ain't got nobody else, God said, I'll be the two. So stop going around saying, I ain't got nobody to agree with me. God said, I'll be the two. You need somebody to agree with me? Get in my word. My word will agree with you, and I'll be the two. Shout hallelujah. I'm closing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, I made up my mind. Hallelujah. I want you to hear your heart, pastor's heart. I made up my mind that I'm going to do everything within the power of my body, my spirit, and my mind to win the loss now. When God said to me, he said it. I was downstairs praying. He said it so loud, it was like somebody reverberating in my mind. Leave the 99. Go get the one. And really, I took it like, oh my. I've been spending too much time with the 99 and not near enough time with the one. And see, that's the way it is in the body. Do the body need healing? Yes. Does it need strengthening? Yes. But you know, we done tasted of the good word of God. We've been baptized. You've been filled with the Holy Ghost. Hebrews said, now it's time to go on unto what? Perfection. We already got it. Got what? Power, instructions, and commandment. Well, if I got all that, what am I supposed to do? What's hindering me? Nothing. Remember when Philip was caught up by the Spirit into that desert place and the man was riding on the chariot on the whatever he was riding. Hallelujah. Amen. He came down and Philip went over there and talked to him. Hallelujah. And began to explain to him. He said, well, what hindered me from being what? Baptized. Philip was carried there on what? Purpose. Now the man was coming to the city. That's not the issue. The issue was God found him. And let me say you something, you know, hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. God wasn't lost. We were. He found us. Shout hallelujah. Glory to God. Why? Looking for us. And when that man heard the gospel preached to him, he immediately received it and left, going back to his country, a new convert that maybe had led his whole country into the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. Your one conversion by witnessing can change a whole family tree. Get up and go. Now, listen. We want the easy way. And it is easy. My yoke is easy. My burdens are light. The way of the transgressor is hard. The rebellious is what? Dwelling on what? Dry land is hard for the rebellious. That's why some people don't understand. I done got so dry. I'm just so dry. I promise you, check it out, and you'll find yourself being rebellious. And in your rebellious, you created a climate spiritually of what? Dryness. Ain't no dryness in obedience. That's joy in obedience. That's power in what? Obedience. Hallelujah. 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 I've said this before. The internet, Facebook, Twitter, and whatever can be one of the most powerful tools for the kingdom of God that I've ever known. But most of the time, it's just people expressing their what do you call it? Venting. Putting all that stuff out there. Not going to win one person to Christ. Now put on there, Jesus saved. Hit me back. Do they do it on Facebook? I don't know. Twitter, hit me back. Jesus saved. You interested? Hit me back. You ain't even got to leave your house. Right there in your living room. Hit me back. Y'all don't want to talk to me. Hallelujah. Yeah, you know, you say some junk, hit me back. Man, I'm going to hit you up. But when it comes to the goodness of God, hit me back. Listen, God healed my body. Anybody out there sick? Hit me back. I'll pray for you. That's the gospel of Jesus Christ, using every avenue that God has afforded us. And every time God creates something that will bless the kingdom, the devil will seek to pervert it. Amen? Just like many of us have been saved, wonderfully filled with the Holy Spirit, and we made some mistakes. And the devil keeps that holding that mistake over our head so that we won't go tell nobody. No, when you run into that person, and they say, well, I heard about you. You said, you heard right. I was living for God, but I got off track. But God brought me back, and I'm here to win you. Look what he says. But wait for the promise of the Father, which said he, ye have what? Heard of me. For John truly baptized with what? Water. And all of us need to be baptized in water. If you ever get saved, go on, part of the Great Commission is to be baptized in water. Amen? Hallelujah. But ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. So that's a promise that God is still keeping. Hallelujah. Anybody that want it, God will baptize them. All you got to do is come with a what? Amen, a surrender life. Here I am, God. And then see, listen, born again people are wonderful and they're saved. But until you get empowered with God, you're going to have a lot of failure. Because you don't have all that you need to stand up. Shout hallelujah. Yeah, and listen, I know wonderfully saved, born again people that have not received the Holy Ghost and don't really believe in it. And they have failure after failure after failure. It ought not be. No, come get some what? Power. Some dunamis. Some dynamite power. Where you look at the devil and say, get out of my face. Where you can reject lust and perversion and unrighteous relationship. No, I'm not going there. Why? I belong to God. My body belongs to God. My mind belongs to God. I'm not going there. Shout hallelujah. I just dare you today, go home and pray. and say, God, what about this? What about what the pastor said? I don't even want you to take what I'm saying. Go home and ask God, what about it? God, don't tell you to get busy. I'll eat this pew right here. Why? God is in a hurry, all nation. He's in a hurry. But I want you to know something. So is Satan. Man, the scripture says in Peter, he's going about seeking whomever he may what? Devour. He's in a hurry. The states the other day, and I close with this. In Missouri, Alabama, I never got what the other state was. Illinois have come up with passing a law that'll almost not allow abortion in any form at any time. Well, man, all of them folk up there that's running for president, they're all mad because they believe that we ought to be able to kill a baby at any time. Shout hallelujah. They tell you, the woman's right. No, 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 no. What about the baby's right? Who's advocating for the baby? You need to get out there, brother head preach this morning. Step up, step out, and step in. He says, time for the church. Step up. We've been too quiet. Step. Amen. Praise God. Step out. Get out there where the devil is fighting. Get out there in his arena. The world, the Bible calls the devil the god of this world. Get out there because God has given you power and authority over all the power of the devil. Amen. And we can begin to bring Jesus Christ, the reward of his suffering, and all heaven will begin to rejoice. And you're talking about an outpouring. You're talking about an atmosphere full of the glory of God. God will rejoice over the sinners that get what? Saved. Just like the Father in Luke 15, what? Rejoice and call the neighbor. Hey, y'all, come on. We're going to have a party. We're going to have a celebration. He that was lost is now what? Found. If you really want to have a high service, amen, let's make it about the lost. Glory to God. Somebody come out of sin and get saved. On a, amen. Turn you on. See, if I come out of, never mind, hallelujah. I say I'm closing. Hallelujah. Let me read this last verse. Acts chapter 2. Shout hallelujah. Verse number 38 says, these people have been hearing Peter preach the gospel. Hallelujah. Handiyashaya. Verse 37 says, now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart. That's what witnessing does. It pricks people in their heart. That anointing that's in your life as you share with them about the goodness of God and how you fail God and how they're failing God. But God wants to bring them out. It will prick their what? Hearts. And you can tell when somebody's heart is being pricked because they get humble. Glory to God. And after a while, man, that fish ready to be what? Brought in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said, hallelujah. Handiyashai. He said, verse 37, he said, now when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren. Look at the sinner man saying, what shall we do? See, the wicked is just looking for somebody to tell them what to do. I know, I've been arrogant. I know what it's like to be out there. But down in my inner man, there were times when I was saying, what am I going to do? I was tired of working for the devil, but I didn't know how to get out of it. I would have days where I didn't go with my friends and party and do stuff. I'd get quiet by myself because I'd say in the nighttime, after being all night long, you know, I'd come in 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, praise God, I was saying, if I'm having so much fun, why am I so unhappy? See, the enemy done sold the goods to the world, saying, it's all good, but it ain't good until they get their drink time after time. You got to get high today, go get high tomorrow. But God, God can set you on fire. Glory to God. How many remember when you were just doing that same old thing over and over? You know why? Because your father, the devil, was telling you to do it over. But one day, you heard the voice of Jesus. Say, come unto me, all you that labor and heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. And God brought you out. I say, and God brought you out. Aren't you glad he brought you out? Aren't you thankful God brought you out? Isn't God worthy? Well, why don't we give him something? Give him something back. He gave us something. Give him something back. Somebody say hallelujah. Look, I'm not a television preacher like some preachers. I don't have their ability, their skills. I'm just a plain, simple, regular old Joe. If you want to be saved, there's a Savior. If you want to be healed, there's a healer. If you want to be delivered, there's a deliverer. If you want to be made whole, there's a God that will make you every whit whole. Stand to your feet.
It's a new song, but I want you to catch it. Say sanctify. Sanctify.